Good evening and welcome to ATV News. My name is Shalama Lawson. On tonight's bulletin, Harare women express concern over rising rape figures. Green Zimbabwe spearheads an environmental project. A painting exhibition opens at Gallery Delta. And Zimunya is becoming the music hub in Manicaland. With cases of rape on the increase, women in Harare no longer feel safe on the streets and are calling on stiffer penalties for rapists. Jairo Saunyama gives us the story.
Women in Harare are living in perpetual fear of rape attacks as cases of sexual abuse of women and children are on the increase. According to medical statistics, 150 women and girls are raped every month and 16% are infected with HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. In an interview with ATV, women condemned the rape of women and children.
We are no longer safe wherever we are. It's like we are walking in chains because you are killing us. These rapists, they are killing us and we are afraid of them.
I think those rapists must never be given bail, and it must be law that no matter what, under any circumstance, they must not be given bail because these bails encourage corruption.
Some women called on courts to impose stiffer penalties on rapists.
I think vanhu vanorepa vanofanira kuiswa kupiwa kana life in jail kana kubviswa nengo dzavo kuti vasapamhise mhosva idzodzo. Vanhu vanofanira kuwedzera whatever my years avaipa for vanhu ma rapists so that zvinoenderana zvinova affecta in any way.
According to police statistics, last year alone, 3,172 cases of rape involving both women and children were reported, compared to 2,883 in 2010. Reporting for ATV in Harare, Zimbabwe.
A group of environmentalists known as Green Zimbabwe are appealing for funding to carry out a reforestation project in Mudasa district. Andrew Mambundiani reports.
Some members of the Rastafarian community from Penalonga in Manicaland have embarked on an exercise to plant trees in Mutasa district, which has suffered from years of deforestation. Deforestation in the country is estimated to be around 330,000 hectares per year. The group called Green Zimbabwe is planning to plant 50,000 trees before the end of this year.
Gorineri pa tree planting tangatine chivimba chekuda kujikara about 50,000 magam trees. Asin
Green Zimbabwe, a cultural group formed 3 years ago, is now appealing for financial assistance to expand the project.
Atina zvigu zvakakwana zvekushandisa kuti tinge tinonyatso kubudira mune zvatinoita. Pari zvino tingori nenzvimbo nesu vanhu vacho vashoma 4 vanotungamira asi ticha buda pari zvino. Hapana nenyaya kuti zvekushandisa zvacho zviringe zvekudini zvekutirasisa zvekudaita kwanisa kuwana rubatsiro. Rokuti tinge tinobatsirikana handofunga pari zvino zvinhu zvedu zvaidai zvane pane chimwe chidanho chiri pamusoro.
The unsustainable cutting down of trees has affected the livelihoods of many people in the area.
Kushayikwa kuri kuita miti muno Mpenalonga kuri kutibata zvakanyanya sesu madzimai nekuti kazhinji ndiwo unoswera pamba. Waswera pamba uchada kuona kuti vana vadya here uchabika senguva ino yekuti magetsi edu ari kuenda zvakanyanya nguva zhinji. Nekuti huni ndidzo dzatinenge tichinyanya kuda.
Kutobikisa huni chaiko chaiko vanhu varotonetseka. Hamuchina huni.
Firewood constitutes 49% of the total energy used in Zimbabwe, with over 90% of households depending on wood for energy. Zimbabwe commemorates National Tree Planting Day on the first Saturday of December each year as a counter strategy to deforestation. Reporting for ATV in Mutare, Zimbabwe.
A one-month painting exhibition has opened at Gallery Delta in Harare, where a group of artists are competing to win the best award. Jairo Saunyama gives us the report.
Art enthusiasts on Wednesday night converged at the Gallery Delta to witness the opening of a one-month painting exhibition. The exhibition, titled The Contenders, will see four local painters battling for glory until August 31. The main objective of the exhibition is to introduce an all-male contemporary art competition.
And the reason why we chose the title Contenders is to try to introduce this, these five artists into the Zimbabwean, contemporary Zimbabwean art market, so that people can understand that there is a dimension, a new dimension when it comes to Zimbabwean contemporary art.
Artists welcomed the exhibition, which they said it would enable them to showcase their talents.
I'm happy to be included because, for a long time, we always need these type of shows. It motivates us to go far.
The opportunity, discusses to commodity, imagine. Ma artists, we talk about Namkana, or others who have a platform,
Arts enthusiasts to grace the opening ceremony hailed the artists for their work.
I've been coming to those exhibitions for quite a while, and I'm always impressed with the talent of the Zimbabwean artists. I really find it's great what they do, and the paintings show a lot of skill and a lot of potential.
Some of the artistry that is being displayed here is mainly promotes our culture as Zimbabweans.
Meanwhile, the 37-year-old gallery faces closure due to financial problems, thereby threatening the future of many artists.
We have been heavily dependent on donor foundation, and most of the donors that we go to seem to complain, or not seem, but are highlighting that there's been serious budget cuts. So we work on a commission where we only manage to sell, that's how we get our monies, and that has diminished over a couple of months ago.
Reporting for ATV in Harare, Zimbabwe.
Zimunya Township is fast becoming a music hub in Manicaland province. The township has produced many successful musicians such as Ya Weyla and Jusa Mupostori. Andrew Mambundiani gives us more.
Zimunya Township is a little known suburb, yet it has churned out a number of musicians in the Manicaland province. Some musicians from the township speak about their rise to fame.
Chinetika mugutare Zimunya. Muzimunya hatingati mafaro kana tinofarisa asi kuti tiri kuinzira kutsvaga maemployment hamuna industry ndo chinichikutanga saka unotiona kuti vamwe vanouya kumusic vakawanda vanouya kumusic vachitoda kuita music but havazokwanisa kusvika padestination yavo.
Zimunya has acted as a springboard for many renowned musicians, and many still have an attachment to the township.
Kuna Jawila, kuna Nayang E. Namuwa au Asatadin Asumuka Steri, kuna na X Cooper.
Tuna Young One, Arima Zimunya, Okuimba Zinoirema. Tuna Jusa Mpostori, Anzi Shinuzachwe Ine Jandineza, Arima Zimunya, Kozoita Mfana Sky.
Musicians from the township promised to popularize their music locally and beyond.
Zimunya kanjumbuka dakodoko, katuda kwegadzira tikaite chitumbuisa.
With the enthusiasm and commitment shown by Zimunya musicians, the township may soon be a hub of the music industry in Zimbabwe. Reporting for ATV in Mutare, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. Good night.